Ayo, it's Alert Gaming, when we back with another NBA 2K20 video, and today we gonna be covering Lob City Finisher. Is it worth putting on your player after the recent patch, or is it just throwing away? Before we even get started with the video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and turn on that noti bell so you don't never miss a single video, and we back. So the description of Lob City Finish improves a player's ability to successfully finish a layup or dunk. The shot cannot, it must be taken so you can receive the boost. So the last part of that just means you have to finish the lob. That's it. It can be a layup or dunk. But the badges that you want to go along is Contact Finisher. If you can get Contact Finisher, Relentless, and Slithery, you're going to be getting a lot easier dunk. And you do not need Lob City like that high, honestly. You do not need it that high. You can put it on Bronze, and you're going to be catching easy boards. One thing you want to also equip is that Quick First Step. Quick First Step unpluckable, so people cannot rob you. I have Contact Dunk, so I unlock the layup. I have Jordan Kilmer layup package. This is one of my favorite layup packages because of how unblockable it is. You get some of the most unblockable dunks that you see. You're going to be seeing the gameplay that I am getting easy contact dunks and I'm cutting to the rim. I'm going to be explaining. I'm going to have the gameplay at the very end of it. I just wanted to show you how the dunk package itself looks and how are you going to be getting these contact dunks. I know I'm going to be getting some questions too. Alert, should I put it to Hall of Fame? What should I put it on? I suggest, honestly, if you know your teammate, you can put it on Bronze. If you're playing with randoms, I would suggest putting on Silver because that just gives you that extra boost. If you're going to be grinding finishing badges, put this on Hall of Fame, take it to my career, and you're going to be catching every lob and you'll be going to be getting these badges. But for us, we play only at the park, so we do not need to put it on Hall of Fame. Do not put this on Hall of Fame unless you're planning to take it to my career. I would not even suggest putting a Hall of Fame. Put a Silver or Bronze, those going to be your key. It's going to be the bread and butter. Those worked really good. A contact dunk, of course, Contact Finisher, and Lob City, they work really well together because you're getting those contact dunks most of the time. And another badge that allows you is that Quick First Step because you get that boost. The thing you and your passer need to get on point is your chemistry needs to be like, he needs to watch you. I can say it to your passer is, as we get some chemistry, take him to the park or whoever you're going to be playing with, and you're going to be getting easy contact dunks. As you can see right there, you need to get a little bit of momentum if you do not have any standing dunks. For me, I'm able to get contact dunks, standing dunks. Like you can see right there, I didn't need no momentum right there. I did not need no momentum to be able to get that standing dunk right there. I do have it on Bronze, and I have Contact Finisher on Gold. This game, I did not have it on Hall of Fame. Just to show you guys that you do not need it on Hall of Fame. You do not need it Hall of Fame. All you gotta watch for is the fact that your point guard needs to be able to watch your lane. That's it. Nothing else that crazy. Right now, as you can see, my guy's behind me. There is nothing. As soon as you get like even 2 inches in front of the guy behind you, if your guy is behind you, that's an easy finish. That's an easy finish every time. The real question is this badge worth it after the recent patch, after patch 12, where 2K said they fixed the lobs? I'ma say yes and no, because the fact that this badge comes down to 60% you with your teammate having good timing and chemistry where you're able to pass the ball to each other, 15% the badge, and the rest is 2K. The reason I say 15% is because I played with this badge on Hall of Fame, from Hall of Fame to Bronze to everything else in between, and I can tell you I catch lobs the same way. I call lobs with it and without it, honestly. It comes down to timing. Timing is the most important aspect of this badge. That's why after 2K fixed it, I still do get animations where that my lobs are not properly and they're not the way I want them. But this badge, you want to put it, mess around with it, Bronze and Silver. If you're gonna be farming rep, and you're gonna be in my career. Put it on Hall of Fame, and you're gonna be grinding rep extremely easy. If you're just gonna be having a lot of fun at the park, put it on silver and bronze, and you're gonna be catching lobs regardless. It's gonna be a lot of fun, and you do not need to waste it. Put it on Hall of Fame. Do not put this badge on Hall of Fame. And you're going to be saving yourself that extra point, and you're going to be having a lot of fun. I hope y'all enjoyed this shorter type of video. If y'all did, don't forget to leave a comment or a like on the video, and I would really appreciate that. I'm going to catch y'all on the next video, and I'm out.